This research work is absolutely insane, and it is not about bubbles. Now, I hear you asking, Dr. Carroll, why would you say that? There is nothing but bubbles here, literally nothing else. Yes, yes, you're right, but no, that's not the point. Let me try to explain. It just uses bubbles to help visualize something that is otherwise incredibly difficult to show. And that is vorticity. Vorticity means tiny little whirlpools inside of a fluid flow, and it shows where the fluid is rotating. That is super important for predicting hurricanes, tornadoes, or to know how water would wrap around different objects. But there are two problems here. One, it is difficult to visualize them. Often, it's just air. So, bubbles here are not the point. They are there to show us the fluid flows. And two, unfortunately, that is incredibly hard to compute. None of these previous methods do it that well. You see, every little tiny whirlpool is being constantly twisted and stretched, and they fall apart into millions of even tinier whirlpools, which in turn, okay, you know that this goes on and on, and the simulators are not up to the task. Look, some of them even blow up and stop. I don't blame them, this is super mega hard, and it is genuinely insane that this work can pull it off. Simulating fluid flow along this something SAR, wow, look at all that incredibly beautiful detail. And look at the David statue fuming because it took him 1,006 episodes to make it to 2-minute papers, no problem. All of these are finally possible. Or, get this, a rotating propeller underwater. Just look at how beautiful that is. And all this is possible through human ingenuity. No AI used whatsoever. Okay, how? The paper is tough, but I'll try to tell you exactly how in so simple words. I think you'll be surprised. Dear fellow scholars, this is 2-Minute Papers with Dr. Caro Zsolnai Fehér. Dr. Caro. So, this is a simulator. We slice the 3D space up into these little sugar cubes, and at each of these corners, we normally compute things like velocity and pressure, how fast the fluid flows there, and how hard it pushes others. Now, here's the genius idea to make this better suited for vortices. 1. We still slice the world into tiny sugar cubes and compute the usual suspects like velocity and pressure. Okay, but now, get this, inside of these cubes we also put particles, and these particles ride the flow like tiny, tiny little weather balloons. And here is the genius part. Every little balloon has a little person in it. And this person remembers all the trauma he was subjected to. This much twisting, this much pulling. A bit like one of these silly old body change movies. And because of this, we don't lose the details when the fluid is moving. Okay, so here's how the experts would say what we just said. This is the vortex in cell method revived with a vorticity-based particle flow map formulation and an evolved flow map Hessian. So, sugar cubes, and balloons, and people with trauma. What's not to like? Okay, so, is it any good? Ooh, you bet your papers it is. Now hold on to your papers, fellow scholars, because the result is that this one retains vortices up to 30 times longer than previous techniques. That is, I'm out of words. So, let's celebrate with a wind tunnel test. This was possible before, but not at this fidelity. Propellers, wings, and fins finally look and behave correctly. That is a complete game changer. What a time to be alive! In the future, using this, we might get cleaner predictions for extreme weather, which may save many, many lives in the future. And we haven't even mentioned quieter cars and jets might be designed using this in the future. I am salivating here. What an incredible paper. But it's not perfect. I'll tell you about its limitations in a moment. And what absolutely blew my mind when reading this paper is that the new method can keep two vortex rings from merging. and it does it far longer than anyone thought possible. In every other previous simulator, these rings crash into each other and smear out after a few leaps or less. And this one just keeps frogging. And did you know that they give all this knowledge away for free for all of us? Thank you so much. I bet everyone is there celebrating. Let me come in and... Wait a minute. It's been out for a while now, and nobody knows about it. Nobody is talking about it. Nobody! This is why two-minute papers exist. It is financially a terrible idea to do this. This is why no one else is doing it. The good idea is to jump into whatever the current drama is and print money and views. Well, we don't do that here. However, to be able for us to keep doing this, we need your help in saving these papers, so please like, subscribe, hit the bell icon, and don't forget to leave a really kind comment. This also helps you get the good stuff from the YouTube algorithm. Now, before the limitations, kinda random, but I also have a new hobby channel where I sneak out of the lab to play the guitar every now and then. Look, 9 subscribers! Link is in the description. Okay, limitations, 2 things. 1, it is not great at super complex geometries, and 2, it does not do two-way solid fluid coupling. That means that the object pushes the water, but the water does not push the object back. Ah, and 3rd, no free surface splashes. So, let's not get carried away here, the glorious applications might be still 1 or 2 papers away, but they could come any moment. And we are going to be here to talk about it. But just think about it, retaining vortices 30 times longer in just 1 paper. Yes, please. Here you see me running the full DeepSeek AI model through Lambda GPU cloud. 671 billion parameters, running super fast and super reliably. This is insane. I love it, and I use it on a regular basis. Lambda provides you with powerful NVIDIA GPUs to run your own chatbots and experiments. Seriously, try it out now at lambda.ai/papers or click the link in the description.